Today's recipe is a mac and cheese bites. Who doesn't like a good mac and cheese recipe? This is my go-to one, which I found recently. The good thing about a mac and cheese bites recipe is that you can take it wherever you go. It's just like in a cupcake tin that you bake it. So you can take it for a picnic, you can send it for your kid's snack. It's a mess-free one. You must try this one. So let's go through the ingredients. There's 250 grams of cooked pasta. I've used a semolina and a wheat pasta. It's an elbow pasta. You can use any packaged pasta and follow the instructions of your company. Then we have 2 tablespoons of butter. We have 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour, 2 cups of milk, 2 cups of cheese. I've used a pizza cheese. And there's also 60 grams or around half a cup of cream cheese. I find that it gives a lot of flavor to the whole pasta. And we have salt and pepper to taste and bacon bits, which is fried. If you want, you can avoid the bacon or you can add it because that gives a whole burst of flavor. So let's start by making a cheese sauce. A cheese sauce is something you need to know, even if it's for a pie or any other pasta or lasagna that you make, cheese sauce is a must. This is a cheese sauce that you can adapt to anything that you want. So let's start. So for the cheese sauce, we'll start by adding 2 tablespoons of butter. I've used unsalted butter. As soon as it melts, we'll add 2 tablespoons of flour. Whatever the quantity, usually the butter and the flour are the same quantity. Once the butter is melted, we add 2 tablespoons of flour. You want to get a smooth mix like this. At this stage, I would suggest that you use a whisk so that there are no lumps. According to your taste, you can add garlic powder or granulated garlic, mince it and put it to add flavor. At this stage, you add the milk. After you put the flour in, always make sure it's at a low flame because otherwise it tends to get lumpy because the flour and the butter together, if not mixed properly and if not mixed at the right temperature, tends to get lumpy and then you wouldn't know what to do. Now the sauce is starting to thicken. At this stage, we can add both the cheese. This is a pizza cheese that I have. You can add any flavor cheese to your liking. This is around 2 cups. Recently, I found out that the cream cheese flavor gives a fabulous new burst of cheese flavor to the whole pasta sauce. So I've added cream cheese in this recipe. This is around 60 grams. Cream cheese is generally a soft cheese. So what I usually do is I put it in the freezer so that it hardens, so it's easier to grate then. Otherwise it becomes a little mushy and difficult to handle. If you can see, you're getting a lovely cheesy texture. You can heat it a little longer to get it thicker. At this stage, you can also add a beaten egg. I have not added this, but an egg also gives a great flavor to this. So now the cheese sauce is ready. This is also known as a bechamel sauce or a mornay sauce. So this is a sauce without egg. If egg is added, then it's not a mornay sauce. To this, you can add like a pinch of nutmeg. That also gives a lot of flavor. Or you can add, because of the cheese, you have to be very careful about the salt content. So add salt and pepper to your taste. The sauce is ready and we are going to add this to the already cooked pasta. Give it a good stir. At this stage, you can add some parsley or some bacon bits. Or you can leave out the bacon bits if it doesn't suit your taste. Now that the pasta is evenly coated, you preheat the oven to 200 degrees centigrade and take a muffin tray like this and grease it with any flavorless oil. This is a non-stick tray, but I still put a little more oil because you want to unmold it perfectly. You can add a spoonful of pasta like this. At this stage, you can add some more bacon bits. and some more cheese if you like it cheesy. Now we are ready to bake. Like I said, make sure the oven is preheated to a temperature of 200 degrees centigrade. Bake it for 20 minutes until it turns golden brown. Now the mac and cheese bites are ready and it's taken from the oven. As you can see, it's all turned a little golden and now you know it's ready. So wait for around 5 minutes to unmold and there you have a perfect snack, either for a birthday party, a tea party, or to send to kids to school, or if you're going on a picnic. It's so easy to take and carry that it's such a mess-free way of eating mac and cheese.